Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the early effect in the BJT. Now in the last couple of videos, we have seen the large signal and the small signal model of the BJT. And during the discussion of these models, we have assumed that when the BJT is operating in the forward active region, then for the fixed value of the base emitter voltage, even if we increase the voltage between the collector and the emitter terminal, then also the collector current remains constant. But actually if you see, then there is some slope. That means as we increase the voltage VC, then the collector current also slightly increases. So let us understand the reason behind it. So let's say there is one NPN transistor and it is biased in the forward active region. That means the base emitter junction is forward biased while the collector base junction is reversed biased. Now, as the base emitter junction is forward biased, so the depletion region between the base and the emitter will be very narrow. On the other end, as the collector base junction is reverse biased, so the depletion region between the two will be wider. Now, for the fixed value of voltage VB, as we increase the voltage between the collector and the base region, or effectively, when we increase the collector to emitter voltage, then this collector to base region will get more reverse biased. And because of that, the width of the depletion region will increase. So due to that, if you see, the effective base width will reduce. That means for the fixed value of voltage VB, this base width is the function of the voltage VC. That means by varying this voltage VC, we can change the base width. And this effect is known as the base width modulation. So due to the reduction in the effective base width, now the chances of the recombination in the base region will reduce. So now, due to this narrower base width, more electrons will be able to cross this base region without the recombination. And due to that, we can say that the collector current IC will increase. That means for the given value of the base emitter voltage, as we increase the collector to emitter voltage, then the collector current IC will increase. And this effect is known as the early effect. Now, without considering the early effect, if we see the collector current IC, then the collector current IC can be given as IS times e to the power voltage VBE divided by VT, where IS is the reverse saturation current and VT is the thermal voltage. But as we have just discussed, this collector current IC also depends on the voltage VCE. That means as we increase the voltage VCE, then this collector current IC will also increase. Now actually, this reverse saturation current IS is inversely proportional to the base width. That means as the base width reduces, then this reverse saturation current IS will increase. And due to that, the collector current IC will also increase. That means this base width is the function of the voltage VC. But here, to establish the linear relationship between the collector current and the voltage VC, we can assume that this reverse saturation current IS remains the constant. And assuming that, the linear relationship between the IC and the VC can be given by the following expression, where VA is the early voltage. So if we extrapolate these curves on the x-axis, then for a one particular voltage of the VC, the collector current IC will become zero. So the value of the voltage VC at which this occurs is known as the early voltage. So typically for the transistors, this early voltage is in the range of 10 to 100 of volt. So this is the expression of the collector current including the early effect. Now as I said earlier, when the effective base width reduces, then the chances of the recombination in the base region will reduce. Or we can say that the value of alpha will increase. Now this beta can be given as alpha divided by 1 minus alpha. So as the value of alpha increases, then the value of beta will also increase. So let's say due to this early effect, the new value of the beta is equal to beta dash. And this beta dash can be given as beta times 1 plus VCE divided by VA. Now with this early effect, the relationship between the base current and the collector current is still true. That means the collector current IC can be given as beta dash times IB. So from this expression we can say that the base current IB is equal to IS divided by beta times e to the power voltage VB divided by VT. And the emitter current is the summation of this base current and the collector current. So this is the large signal model of the BJT, including the early effect and the corresponding expression of the base, collector and the emitter currents. Now in this expression, let's say this term is equal to IC dash. That is the collector current without including the early effect. That means we can write this expression as IC is equal to IC dash times 1 plus VCE divided by VA. That is equal to IC dash plus VCE divided by VA divided by IC dash. Or we can say that this collector current IC is equal to IC dash plus VCE divided by R0, where R0 is the output resistance and R0 can be given as VA divided by IC dash. So this is the another way to represent the large signal model, including the early effect. So here this current is the total collector current IC, while this current is the IC dash, and this current is equal to voltage VCE divided by R0. Alright, so similarly, now let us see, because of this base width modulation or the early effect, how the small signal model will get modified. Now, so far in the small signal model, we have assumed that even if there is an incremental change in the voltage VCE, then the small signal current remains the same. That means the small signal current IC can be still given as GM times Vπ. But now, let us see, due to this early effect, how it will get modified. So to understand that, let us say some fixed DC voltage VB and the voltage VCE is already applied between the base emitter and the collector emitter terminals. And on top of this collector emitter voltage, a small perturbation delta VCE is also applied. So because of this perturbation, now let's say the total collector current is equal to IC plus delta IC. And this total current can be given as IS times e to the power voltage VB divided by VT times 1 plus voltage VCE plus delta VCE divided by VA. So if we separate the two term, then the one term will be the collector current and the second term will be the delta IC. So this delta IC can be given as IS times e to the power voltage VB divided by VT times delta VCE divided by VA. And let's call this term as the IC dash. That means delta IC is equal to IC dash times delta VCE divided by VA. So as you can see, for the given change in the voltage VCE, the change in the collector current is linear. Now of course over here, this IC dash involves the nonlinear term, but for the fixed value of the voltage VB, this term will be the constant. So as far as the change is concerned in the collector current, then it is the linear. That means the ratio of this delta VCE to the delta IC can be given by the resistance. And let's call this resistance as the output resistance, because here both delta IC and the delta VCE are the output current and the output voltages. That means from this we can say that R0 is equal to voltage VA divided by IC dash. Now if the value of this early voltage is much higher than the voltage VCE, then we can say that this IC dash is approximately equal to IC. And in that condition, this output resistance can be given as VA divided by IC. So this is the small signal model of the BJT, including the early effect. And this output resistance plays a crucial role in deciding the gain of the BJT amplifier. So as I said earlier, the small signal model is very useful during the AC analysis of the BJT. So in the upcoming videos, we will see that how we can do the AC analysis of the BJT circuit using this small signal model. And using this small signal model, how we can find the different amplifier parameters like the voltage gain, input impedance and the output impedance. So I hope in this video you understood what is early effect in the BJT and because of this effect, how the large signal and the small signal model of the BJT will get modified. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.